demon, I'm going to do a consumer's view of an app called Phile Audio that's been around a few months now. I'm not affiliated in any way with the company. I'm not a computer genius. I am doing this review basically for people that just want to use these apps for everyday use. I'm not a professional reviewer or anything like that, so it's just a simple, straightforward review from somebody who uses this kind of software. Now, if you have a large CD collection, excuse me, like myself, over 1,000, this is invaluable. Now, you'll find it in the App Store, obviously. Easiest way to find it now is type in Phile, which is PH Phile, not F, right? And you'll see that Phile Audio pops up straight away. So click Phile Audio, and there it is. There are no other versions or different ones sounding like that. Okay, I've already installed it. It says I've installed it. Give you a brief outline. There haven't been many reviews of this app. I don't quite understand why, because it is an excellent app. But I think probably because when it first came out, there were quite a few bugs in the actual software. Okay. Now, it'll tell you what's new as well. If you just click more, tell you all about it and what's new in the version. And what's the biggest features is the bug fixes that they've done now. They've done two updates since I had it. And the first time I used it, it was impossible to use. Second time was okay, third time it works a charm. Right, so you download that, it takes about 10 seconds, and then you'll find it in your applications. Okay, and then obviously you click it on in your applications, it will then show up in the dock. So you'll see the icon, it's a little transistor icon like that. So I will start. So you click Phile Audio. And it is a very, very quick responding piece of software. Very, very low CPU usage. Now, the whole point of this is to rip CDs. So you want this to be very, very simple. But before you start, you need to go into preferences. Now, it doesn't come with an MP3 encoder with it. So what you have to do is, it is quite easy to do, is it'll tell you there about downloading and installing an MP3 encoder. So there is a link there to download from the web. Click the download from the web. It will take you to the website in a moment. There we go. And there it is. You just simply click that on, download it to wherever you usually put all your downloads. Keep everything in just download file folder. You can even put it onto your desktop, which will make the life a lot easier. Okay, so when it's been downloaded, this here will be blank where it says installed app because you haven't found it yet. So to find the MP3 encoder, click automatically locate on my computer. Okay, that will then automatically locate the file you just downloaded. Mine's already there, so it's looking for it, but it will just overwrite what's already there. So as you can see there, it is in my downloads folder, lame MP3 encoder 64-bit version, okay? Now, you have several presets, encode mode, and some various others. Now, just give you an explanation of everything. I have it as preset insane. Now that is 320 kilobytes, constant bitrate, lame maximum quality. To me, that is the only way to go, but if you're very, very low on space, I would suggest going down to about 192 kilobits or variable bit rates. But if you've got...
Alert from Phile Audio. Preset insane.
That's my computer talking to me, which really annoys me. So that's installed. Change these by just fast extreme, fast standard, fast medium, preset medium. They're just easy ways, easy terms for you to just click like that instead of having to mess around with all this. Okay. Now, the other thing you need to do then is you'll need a file location. You'll need one for the temporary files and one for the actual MP3 encoded files. So the best thing to do is do it to an external drive if you can. I've got mine on my external drive, which is called My Book. You have File Audio Temp there and New Downloads. The reason I call it New Downloads is so it's just simply easy for me to find everything that I've actually ripped from this piece of software. You have audio file paths format, as simple as it sounds. It tells you everything there. These symbols tell you, so track artist, track name, in what basically tells you what audio, in what order these are when they're ripped. Then there is another excellent part of this software also, is that it will import into iTunes at the same time as importing into your folder on your external hard drive, or if you're using the internal hard drive. So you could click that like that, and that would then import into iTunes and your folder. I don't actually do that, but okay. Disk identification. Anybody knows about FreeDB, you'll know what it is. It's a free database of music files and CD covers and all sorts. So it will find missing track information, it will give you the right. So once you put the CD in, it basically the FreeDB comes into action and it will find everything as tracks, track names, track numbers, the artist, the album, but it will not give you the album cover. I'll come to that in a moment, okay? Application defaults, simple. Click to eject after ripping, very important because it's annoying when you don't do that. So go back, okay? This part here, I just wanted to point out, is the fact that makes this piece of this software quite unique, is you can actually rip it to all of these in one go. So one rip will encode all of these, okay? You can have that and that, that and that. Obviously, it's not something I do personally, but you can. Now, so you've sorted that out, you've got it set to MP3, okay? You've downloaded the MP3 encoder. It's constant bitrate at 322 maximum. Actually, it doesn't make a difference, so I've already set it. The other thing is a little tick this, because it resizes the cover art that you download to the, to the exact width of a proper cover should be. Default genre, it usually comes up okay, but there is a list here, basic list actually, not a very long list, but you can type in your own if you want that. Anyway, so you save settings and you go to device. Now, so the easiest thing to do now is to find a CD to rip. I have Rush. One of my favourite Rush albums, Moving Pictures, and re-release with a DVD. But anyway, here's the CD. I will place it in. Actually, no, before I do that, I will actually quit File Audio, because you can set, when you go into Preferences, System File Preferences, you can set what happens to CDs. So there you go. When you insert a blank CD, blah, 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 blah. But when you insert a music CD, you have a choice of what to do with it. Okay, open iTunes, open other application. I decided to open other applications and then pointed it towards File Audio app. Very, very useful, and I'll show you why. So I then just put the CD in and I wait. Doesn't take long for the CD to be read, depending on how good your DVD and CD drive is. It will then be picked up by File Audio, there you go. It's now finding the free database. Obviously, I have an awful lot there. Rush Moving Pictures, lots and lots and lots of different ones. Okay, I'll just pick a basic one there, okay. I mean, mine isn't a basic one, it includes several other things. So there you go, simple. Rush, album is the artist Rush, album title Moving Pictures, rock genre, so you don't need to change that. It's only one disc. If it was two discs, you could put two, and then two of two when you come to it. Compilation, if it's a compilation. Gapless, if it's something that you don't want any gaps to play through on iTunes, okay? Gapless doesn't always work. It's something I don't use very much. Now, the next thing you'll need to do is you'll need the cover art. Rather than scanning the cover art on your printer scanner and then copying it over, just click Find. Okay, that will come up with various pictures, some which have no relevance to the album whatsoever, but you'll find the one usually. Now, if you look at that one, that's the original master recording. If you've got that version, that's the exact cover you want. This is just a generic Rush moving pictures CD cover. Okay, I will choose that because it's not the right one for me, but it's just fine. And all you do is you click rip. And depending on how fast your CD drive is, it can go faster or it can go slow. So I'm not going to say anything at the moment. I'll just let that go through and speed it up a little bit along the way. But whilst I'm doing that, I'll just show you the folder and as it's being ripped, what happens. Thing here, Phile Audio is one of the best CD rippers at the moment. I know you can rip in iTunes to an MP3 format, but there's no one on the market that I know that will rip into all the formats all at once. But the finding of the album artwork and being able to embed it into each track is the best. So that's my review of Phile Audio. I hope you find it of use. And next review I will be reviewing is this very, very interesting piece here, Playback. Had that a long time. Again, I've delayed reviewing it due to various bugs which have now been worked out, and that will be on my next review. But Phile Audio, I would give it 4 out of 6 stars. Nothing's perfect. 6 is perfect, 5 is extremely good, 4, in my opinion, is very good. And that's that. Thank you. Bye-bye.